We extend a warm welcome to you today, the fourth Sunday of Easter. We continue to invite you to light a candle in your homes in solidarity of this Ascension community. Our gathering song is "We Will Rise Again." Please stand and let us proclaim the risen Lord as we begin our liturgy.
Like a shepherd, I will feed you. I will gather you with care. I will lead you and hold you close to my heart. We will run and not grow weary, for our God will be our strength, and we will fly like the eagle. We will rise again. I am strength to the weary, to the weak I am new life. Though the young
Hallelujah. Our Easter journey continues. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Seems like we were just here just moments ago. Time is really flying. My grandma was right that time just moves along. And we're hurtling towards eternity, to a place of peace and joy. And so let this moment pass, but really take a moment to stop and to focus on the Lord who comes to us with great love and compassion. As we prepare to celebrate this Holy Mass, let's refresh ourselves with the waters of forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, Good Shepherd, you call us to follow you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, True Shepherd, you heal us and strengthen us. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, loving Shepherd, you show us the way. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Amen.
Have mercy, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God has both made Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified." Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart, and they asked Peter and the other apostles, "What are we to do, my brothers?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promises made to you and to your children and to all those far off, whomever the Lord our God will call." He testified with many other arguments and was exhorting them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted this message were baptized, and about 3,000 persons were added that day.
The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The response appointed for today is taken from Psalm 23. The refrain is, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want."
So green. He leads me to the quiet stream. He gives me strength and guides me in his ways. He renews his promises each day. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing shall want. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. He is my guide, my shepherd and my king. And in my fear he offers peace. Though I walk afraid, you will protect me, I'll be saved. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, if you are patient when you suffer for doing what is good, this is a grace before God. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving an example that you should follow in his footsteps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was insulted, he returned no insult. When he suffered, he did not threaten. Instead, he handed himself over to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins and his body upon the cross, so that, free from sin, we might just live righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed, for you have gone astray like sheep, but you have now returned to the shepherd and the guardian of your souls.
The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever does not enter the sheepfold through the gate, but climbs over elsewhere, is a thief and a robber. But whoever enters through the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens it for him, and the sheep hear his voice. As the shepherd calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has driven out all of his own, he walks ahead of them, and the sheep follow him, because they recognize his voice. But they will not follow a stranger. They will run away from him, because they do not recognize the voice of strangers." Although Jesus used this figure of speech, the Pharisees did not realize what he was trying to tell them. So Jesus said again, "Amen, amen, I say to you, I am the gate for the sheep, and all who come before me are thieves and robbers. But the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved, and will come in and out and find pasture. A thief comes only to steal and slaughter and destroy. I came so that they might have life and have it abundantly." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Padre Martín. He oído que puede celebrar la misa en español, ¿sí?
Father Martin, I understand you can celebrate the Mass in Spanish. Is that true? I do celebrate the Spanish Mass. My Spanish is... But the largest Spanish Mass I ever celebrated, it wasn't here at Ascension. It wasn't anywhere in the United States. It was 13 years ago in Baghdad, Iraq, where thousands were hired from Central and South America to work supporting our military. They worked primarily in very dangerous places, and we can have a long discussion about that. But where most of them did work was at the entry control point, the gate, where everybody came into the base. You know, a military base has, you know, a lot of barbed wire around it, a lot of protection all the way around the base, the perimeter. You're trying to protect everybody inside the best you can. And so there's only usually just one entryway, one access point, the ECP. And if you work at the ECP, it can be very dangerous. I'd go out there to visit a lot of these young soldiers out there, many of them from Central America, Peru. One of them is my best friend now from Peru. South America, we just visited a few weeks ago, visited the family, and they're really struggling now with the coronavirus there. But I remember how they would take comfort from the Mass, and I would go out to visit them along the perimeter, and there at the gate, they'd be with mirrors looking under the cars, making sure there weren't bombs underneath the cars coming into the compound. They would make sure that everybody had the right clearance, the pass to come in. They would make sure that cars that were not yet cleared did not race towards the gate to explode. So it was a very dangerous job. You can think, some of you, maybe if you're reading your stories or seeing the movies, you think about an army fort, or you think about a castle, how they'd have a ramparts around the castle. There'd always be that one entry control point. And so the one entry control point is really important. And we hear about that in our gospel today, that the good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. He becomes the gate. And if you've been to Italy or different places where you see shepherds and sheep, you'll notice that in the hillsides they have these corrals. The shepherd builds out of stones this stone corral. And there's no door anywhere. And as you're hiking along, you're seeing these little circles of stone around. And then I was told that what happens is at night, if the shepherd's far from home, he would take the sheep into the corral, and the shepherd would lay down and sleep right there. The shepherd becomes the gate. The shepherd protects the sheep from the wolves. The shepherd is the entry control point. Nobody can get in. No wolves can get in. We know how it's important to stay safe. You think about the hospitals today. All the nursing homes, they have an entry control point. They don't want the virus to come in. They don't want the enemy to come in to destroy lives. And so this is a war going on. And so we have to be really smart about our entry control point and our security to protect those inside. And we know the human element, sometimes we have failed. Sometimes we know the virus has gotten into a hospital or gotten into a nursing home or a home or a school or somewhere, and it's just a great disappointment to us all. But we understand how God does not disappoint, how God has provided a kingdom of peace, of joy. He's prepared a place for those who believe, and of his kingdom there will be no end. I want to read to you a little scripture. We hear this all the time here at Ascension. It's from the Book of Wisdom. This is actually from a funeral liturgy. You know, a funeral is not the end for those with faith. We call a funeral a mass of the resurrection. Alleluia. Death is not an end. And so this is reading from the Book of Wisdom, chosen by many people. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. Sounds like coronavirus, doesn't it? But they are in peace. For if before people they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastise a little, they will be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them. And as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And the truth is, he's opened the door to eternal life. The truth is, that door, that entry control point, will never be passed by the evil one. Jesus conquered sin and death. And for those who trust in the Lord, they shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and care is with his elect. Mass of the Resurrection. Certainly, Alleluia is our song. We are an Easter people each and every day of our lives. From the womb to the tomb, we are God's. We are God's people now. What we shall later be has not yet fully come to light, but now we have seen a bit of that light break through. Alleluia. Death is not an end. Death really opens a doorway for all of us that we walk through with faith, hope, and love. God has prepared a place for those who believe in him. Eye has not seen, ear has not heard what God has prepared for those who love him. And so as an Easter people, through all the crisis we're going through, all the difficulties, we understand that entry control point is there, and it's protecting all of our souls. It doesn't mean we're all going to be protected from the virus here. I mean, Peter's got the keys to the door, right? Peter's got the keys to the kingdom. Peter knows what suffering is. Peter was crucified upside down. Andrew was crucified on an X. Many of the apostles suffered greatly. The church is a suffering church. We unite our sufferings to the suffering of Christ. We unite our current struggle with the virus to the struggle of the Lord. We suffer with the Lord, and the Lord carries us through. We pick up our cross, we follow him. We die with Christ, we rise with Christ. That's our faith. So let us have the Lord pour down upon us spiritual courage, that we truly become that best version of ourselves, people of hope and light and goodness in a time of trial and difficulty. Our prayers go out to all of you. May we continue to support one another as best we can, and we look forward to our reunion, if not soon, then in the kingdom of God for all eternity. God bless you. Let us stand and pray together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. The Good Shepherd does not allow the sheep to wander in harm's way. Knowing we are heard, let us pray with confidence.
For our holy shepherds in the church, that they may keep watch at the gate of the Lord's sheepfold, that allowing thieves and robbers to harm the flock and welcoming the Lord when he comes in to call his own.
We pray to the Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who hear the role of shepherd, especially parents of families, and superiors of religious communities, that this day of celebration may bring them our gratitude for all their loving care.
We pray to the
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have gone astray like sheep, especially our own loved ones, that the shepherd and guardian of their souls, our Lord Jesus Christ, may find them and bring them home.
We pray to the Lord,
and thanksgiving for all of the food pantries throughout the country who provide food for people who have never had to ask for food. In thanksgiving for our own social concern volunteers who are providing food locally. In thanksgiving for parishioners who bring food items in baskets in front of the church each week.
We pray to the Lord,
hear our prayer.
For all who have been infected by the coronavirus, for all who are sick and suffering from other ailments, for all who have recently died. We especially remember the baby Sophie Riviera and Rosalie Quioz, that they now be enjoying the everlasting life.
We pray to the
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions closest to our own hearts.
We pray to the
Lord, hear our prayer.
Generous God, you know us each by name. Hear our prayers and let your Holy Spirit fill our hearts. We ask these things in the name of Jesus, your Son, our loving Shepherd, Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. As the table is prepared, and as we reflect on the gifts we offer to the Lord, let us sing, "The King of Love is my Shepherd is, the King of Love my Shepherd is."
The King of Love my Shepherd is, whose goodness fails me never. My nothing lack if I am His, and He is mine forever. When streams of living water flow, with gentle care He leads me. And when the verdant pastures grow,
pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and good of all this holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to claim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring us to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our universal shepherd, John, our bishop, and all the clergy, and all the men and women who serve your people in ministry. Remember all those who have died this past week, especially the deceased members of our parish family, and in particular, Salome and Edgar Cartwright, James Zurbuck, Derek Diesel, Paula Jean Irvin, Paula Robert Digner, James Murta, Margaret Kelly, Mary Jane Barrett. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, her spouse, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise you and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
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 Confident in God's love and mercy, we pray as Jesus taught.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all worry and distress, as we await the blessed hope and the second coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another a reverent bow of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The communion song is Pescador de Hombres, found in the worship aid. We will sing verse 1. Then the Spanish refrain and English refrain, and then verse 3.
Take my hands and direct them.
pray now an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Amen. Okay.
Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Time for some announcements. Well, I can do the announcements. I'm glad you joined us remotely for Mass today, and we appreciate you telling others about the Mass, neighbors, friends, relatives, Catholics, non-Catholics. People from all over the world are sending their responses. We have copies of our bulletin online and copies of the bulletin outside the main doors of the church. If you would like the sacrament of reconciliation or anointing, please email Father Tobin or myself, contact the parish office. If you have any suggestions on how we can better serve you during this challenging time, please let us know. Our prayers are with you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Go forth and glorify the Lord with your life.
Thanks be to God.
And in honor of Mary, in the month of May, let us sing Immaculate Mary, Immaculate Mary.